the solemnity of Good Friday and the Passion of our Lord. Please rise. Let us pray. Almighty God, we ask you to look with loving mercy upon your family, for whom Jesus Christ our Lord was willing to be betrayed and given over to the hands of sinners and to suffer death upon the cross. He who now lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Reading from Isaiah. See, my servant shall prosper. He shall be exalted and lifted up and shall be very high. Just as there were many who were astonished at him, so marred was his appearance beyond human semblance and his form beyond that of mortals. So he shall startle many nations. Kings shall shut their mouths because of him, for that which had not been told them, they shall see, and that which they had not heard, they shall contemplate. Who has believed what we have heard? And to whom has the arm of the Lord been revealed? For he grew up before him like a young plant, and like a root out of dry ground. He had no form or majesty that we should look at him, nothing in his appearance that we should desire him. He was despised and rejected by others, a man of suffering and acquainted with infirmity, and as one from whom others hide their faces. He was despised, and we held him of no account. Surely, he has borne our infirmities and carried our diseases. Yet we accounted him stricken, struck down by God, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions, crushed for our iniquities. Upon him was the punishment that made us whole. And by his bruises, we are healed. All we like sheep have gone astray. We have all turned to our own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he did not open his mouth. Like a lamb that is led to the slaughter, and like a sheep that before its shearers is silent, so he did not open his mouth. By a perversion of justice, he was taken away. Who could have imagined his future? For he was cut off from the land of the living, stricken for the transgression of my people. They made his grave with the wicked and his tomb with the rich. Although he had done no violence, and there was no deceit in his mouth. Yet it was the will of the Lord to crush him with pain. When you make his life an offering for sin, he shall see his offspring and shall prolong his days. Through him, the will of the Lord shall prosper. Out of his anguish, he shall see light. He shall find satisfaction through his knowledge. The righteous one, my servant, shall make many righteous, and he shall bear their iniquities. Therefore, I will allot him a portion with the great, and he shall divide the spoil with the strong, because he poured out himself to death and was numbered with the transgressors. Yet he bore the sins of many and made intercession for the transgressors. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from Hebrews. This is the covenant that I will make with them after those days, says the Lord. I will put my laws in their hearts, and I will write them on their minds. He also adds, I will remember their sins and their lawless deeds no more. Where there is forgiveness of these, there is no longer any offering for sin. Therefore, my friends, since we have confidence to enter the sanctuary by the blood of Jesus, by the new and living way that he opened for us through the curtain, that is, through his flesh, and since we have a great priest over the house of God, let us approach with a true heart in full assurance of faith, with our hearts sprinkled clean from an evil conscience, and our bodies washed with pure water. Let us hold fast to the confession of our hope without wavering, for he who has promised is faithful. And let us consider how to provoke one another to love and good deeds, not neglecting to meet together, as is the habit of some, but encouraging one another, and all the more as you see the day approaching. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Save my tongue, O God. received a band of men and officers from the chief priests and Pharisees. Come hither with lanterns and torches and weapons. Jesus, therefore, knowing all things that should come upon him, went forth. disciples, Lord, to the high priest, and went in with Jesus into the palace of the high priest. But Peter stood at the door without. Then went out that other disciple, which was known unto the high priest, and spake unto her that kept the door, and brought in Peter. Then saith the damsel that kept the door unto Peter, stood there who had made a fire of coals, for it was cold, and they warmed themselves. And Peter stood with them and warmed himself. The high priest then asked Jesus of his disciples and of his doctrine. Jesus answered him,
I spake openly to the world. I ever taught in the synagogue and in the temple, whither the Jews always
sent him out unto Caiaphas the high priest, and Simon Peter stood and warmed himself. They said therefore unto him, unto the hall of judgment, and it was early. And they themselves went not into the judgment hall, lest they should be defiled, but that they might eat the Passover. Pilate then went out unto them, and said,
What accusation bring ye against this man?
They answered and said unto him,
If he were not a malefactor, we would not have delivered him up unto thee, up to thee.
Then said Pilate unto them,
Take ye him and judge him according to your law.
The Jews therefore said unto him, signifying what death he should die. Then Pilate entered into the judgment hall again, and called Jesus and said unto him,
Art thou the King of the Jews?
Jesus answered him,
Thank you.
hast answered.
Thou sayest that I am a king. To this end was I born, and for this cause came I into the world, that I should bear witness unto the truth. Everyone that is of the truth heareth my voice.
Pilate saith unto him, and saith unto them,
I find in him no fault at all, but ye have a custom that I should release unto you one at the Passover. Will ye therefore that I release unto you the King of the Jews?
Then cry they all again, say, saith unto them,
behold, I bring him forth to you, that ye may know that I find no fault in him.
Then came Jesus forth, wearing the crown of thorns and the chief priests, therefore, and officers saw him, they cried out, saying,
crucify him, crucify him, crucify him.
Pilate saith unto them,
take him and crucify him, for I find no fault.
into the judgment hall and saith unto Jesus,
Whence art thou?
But Jesus gave him no answer. Then saith Pilate unto him,
Speakest thou not unto me? Knowest thou not that I have power to crucify thee, and have power to release thee?
Jesus answered,
Thank you. release him. But the Jews cried out, saying,
"We have not let this man go, thou art not Caesar's friend. Whosoever made himself a king speaketh against Caesar."
When Pilate therefore heard that saying, he brought Jesus forth and sat down in the judgment seat in a place that is called the pavement, but in thy Hebrew Gabbatha. And it was the preparation of the Passover, and about the sixth hour, and he said unto the Jews,
"Behold your king."
But they cried out,
"Away with him! Crucify him! Away with him! Crucify him!"
Pilate said unto them,
"Shall I crucify your king?"
The chief priest answered,
Lord, have mercy.
Thank you.
received the vinegar, he
Let us pray, brothers and sisters, for the Holy Church throughout the world.
Almighty and eternal God, you have shown your glory to all the nations through in Jesus Christ. By your Holy Spirit, guide the Church and gather her throughout the world. Help her to persevere in faith, proclaim your name, and bring the good news of salvation in Jesus Christ to all people. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray for Elizabeth and James, our bishops, for Albert, Gerald, Frederick, Paul, and David, our pastors, for Henrietta and Gus, and all servants of the Church, and for all the people of God.
Almighty and eternal God, your Holy Spirit guides the Church and makes her holy. Strengthen and uphold our bishops, pastors, deacons, other ministers, and all lay leaders. Keep them in health and in safety for the good of the Church, and help each of us in our various vocations to do faithfully the work to which you have called us. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray for those preparing for baptism.
Almighty and eternal God, you continue to bless the Church. Increase the faith and understanding of all who are preparing for the sacrament of holy baptism. Give them new birth as your children, and keep them in the faith and the communion of your holy Church. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray for our sisters and brothers who share our faith in Jesus Christ.
Almighty and eternal God, you give your Church unity. Look with favor on all who follow Jesus Christ, your Son. Make all the baptized one in the fullness of faith, and keep us united in the fellowship of love. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray for the Jewish people, the first to hear the word of God.
Almighty and eternal God, long ago you gave your promise to Abraham and your teaching to Moses. Hear our prayers, that the people that you called and elected as your own may receive the fulfillment of the covenant's promises. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray for those who do not share our faith in Jesus Christ.
Almighty and eternal God, enable those who do not acknowledge Christ to receive the truth of the gospel. Help us, your people, to grow in love for one another, to grasp more fully the mystery of your Godhead, and so to become more perfect witnesses of your love in the sight of all peoples. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray for those who do not believe in God.
Almighty God, you created humanity so that all may long to know you and find peace in you. Grant that all may recognize the signs of your love and grace in the world and in the lives of Christians, and gladly acknowledge you as the one true God. Amen. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray for God's creation.
Almighty and eternal God, you are the creator of a magnificent universe. Hold all the worlds in the arms of your care and bring all things to fulfillment in you. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray for those in public office.
Almighty and eternal God, you are the champion of the poor and the oppressed. In your goodness, give wisdom to those in authority, so that all people may enjoy justice, peace, freedom, and a share in the goodness of your creation. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray for those in need.
Almighty and eternal God, you give strength to the weary and new courage to those who lose heart. Heal the sick, comfort the dying, give safety to travelers, free those unjustly deprived of liberty, and deliver your world from all falsehood, hunger, and disease. Hear the prayers of all who call out to you in any time of trouble, that they may have the joy of receiving your help in their need. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Finally, let us pray for all those things for which our Lord would have us ask.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Behold the life-giving cross upon which was hung the salvation of the whole world.
O come, let us worship him.
Behold the life-giving cross upon which was hung the salvation of the whole world.
Oh, come, let us worship him.
Behold the life-giving cross upon which was hung the salvation of the whole world.
Oh, come, let us worship him.
Be seated.
Oh, redeemed the world.